Try this riddle. We will discuss its significance after you have tried answering it. A father and his son were traveling by a car. The car met with an accident. The father died on the spot, while the son was rushed to the hospital. When the doctor saw the son, the doctor said, "This is my child, so I cannot operate upon him." So, who was the doctor?
I think it was his grandfather.
If the father's dead, how can... So it's probably like that the person who died was obviously not the father then.
Maybe it's the grandfather.
Who was the doctor?
I guess he was his father and the father which died, he was his stepfather, I guess.
Guys, I have no clue. The doctor? No, I don't know.
If the father died in a car, must be a stepfather who died in the car, or was the stepfather the doctor?
Maybe that father was the fake father and he had adopted them.
Can I get some time? I don't know, nothing is coming in my head. His dad was gay, so he had two fathers, something like that. Probably, this can be.
Who was the doctor? This is my son. Well, that's a tricky one again. I think you can give me some clue. Maybe a stepfather?
His stepfather?
Christian people, there are some fathers. They worship them. They might be there.
The same stepfather. I thought that.
The mother. The doctor is the mother.
Yeah, so the doctor is the mother of the guy.
His mother.
The answer is, the doctor was the boy's mother. You may have got this one right, but most of the people fail to get it right. It's because the way our mind is programmed by the society, when we think of a doctor, we subconsciously think of a man, even though consciously we are aware that a doctor can also be a woman. The same way when we think of a teacher, we think of a woman, even though a teacher can be a man. Now, what about God? Is God a man or a woman?
I think God is faith. You know, when it comes to faith, the gender doesn't matter.
I don't think there is a man or a woman thing. I just think God is a power.
We can't say anything because no one has seen God in real. And it's just a belief, like many people do believe in him, many people don't, so it's...
Why did you say him?
I don't know, it's just my habit.
No, we have not seen God, so of course we can't say.
That's my answer.
Yeah, like we can't really say. But then, yeah, it's like, it can be a man or a woman, like, you know, there are, yeah.
Even I feel that there's no, you know, like, I don't even believe that there's someone like as God as such.
When we write God, we address him as a male. But there are many female strong goddesses in our Indian culture. Like for example, goddess Durga is a very strong figure in the Hindu gods. So I'm not really sure if that adds, but maybe it can be because there is a mentality, so it's our tendency to address.
Even though most of us may say God has no gender, but we do refer to God as a he and not a she. Of course, there are goddesses in Indian, Greek and other mythologies. But still, when we think of the one supreme being that created and controls the universe, we subconsciously assume it to be a male figure. Perhaps this idea that is so deeply rooted in us is the very root of gender inequality. What do you think? Write to us in the comments below. If you wish to remain updated with more of such videos, don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Thank you for watching.